You've probably seen that clip, Andrew Huberman on Theo Vaughn's podcast, saying that porn spikes dopamine just like cocaine. I'm Dr. Trish Leigh, cognitive neuroscientist, and I want to break down why that actually matters. I want you to know what happens in your brain every time you click on porn. Okay, so when Andrew Huberman says that, this is what he means. Dopamine is actually the neurochemical of motivation. Yes, it's motivation towards pleasure, but the way it's supposed to work in a healthy brain is you have to work for it. You put in the effort, you go out, you meet someone and you connect in real life. You work on a business deal, you go crush a difficult workout and your brain gets dopamine. But when it comes to porn, you hit the easy button and your brain is flooded with 400% dopamine without having to lift a finger. When it comes to explicit matter, there's no effort put in. There's no struggle. There's no working for delayed gratification like it would be in a healthy pursuit. Instead, instant gratification. No struggle, flood of dopamine. This is how porn crushes your internal motivation system. Because with 400% dopamine and no effort, now when you have to put effort in, it feels like a struggle or not worth it. Going to the gym, that's too difficult. Reading a book, totally flat, not enough dopamine. Work, where you used to get dopamine, not enough now. There's not 400% there. Your partner, she begins to look like a low dopamine person instead of the high one she would have been, minus porn. In this way, your brain is totally hijacked by ultra-intense synthetic rewards instead of the pursuit of happiness. That's why so many men tell me that they feel stuck, not just sexually, but that's definitely a situation, but also in their careers, in their health, in their relationships, in the hobbies that they used to love to do. And it's all because this synthetic hijacking is leading them back to porn. They're not able to find the fulfillment in what would have been high dopamine activities, but now have become low dopamine, flat activities. When you hit that synthetic dopamine button, you're no longer building the real neural pathways in your brain back towards healthy motivation and pleasure. And guess what? Neuroscience proves it. I see it every single day on QEEG brain maps. I've seen thousands of them. Okay, so let me break this down for you. The prefrontal cortex is kind of like the captain of the ship of your brain. The captain makes the decisions, he can plan, he can organize, he keeps the rest of the ship running. Now your limbic system in the midbrain gets hijacked by a gorilla down there. That gorilla in the belly of the boat, he wants one thing and one thing only, bananas. Those bananas are like the dopamine hits that you're chasing. Now check this out. If the gorilla takes over the ship, he will just want to find the bananas. He doesn't care where the course is set to. He's not following the map trying to get to the destination. Instead, he's hooked on the bananas. This is exactly what's happening in your brain. The limbic system, it goes on overdrive. Bananas. The prefrontal cortex, that captain of the ship, he's asleep at the helm. So you know what happens. The dopamine is where you're motivated back to, and all of those executive function skills, they tank. Impulse control goes down. Judgment down. Now you're single-mindedly driven back to porn. And if you're not there yet, it's just a matter of time. This all leads to anxiety, brain fog, depression, low motivation. So it's not just that you're addicted to porn. It's that you've been derailed from building that healthy lifestyle that would be giving you dopamine. you're missing out on the work, the hobbies, and the relationships that you could have, all for effortless dopamine spikes. So every time you consume porn, and especially if you edge for more and more dopamine, and especially if you assist your completion with porn, you get a huge dopamine spike, 400%. And what that means is you're derailed. Now your prefrontal cortex, he's lost power. This creates a significant imbalance, not only in your brain, but in your life. It shows up in how you think, how you feel, your hormones, your habits, your lifestyle, your decisions. Okay, so let's talk about the solution now. I'm sure you've heard me say it before, maybe thousands of times. If you want to reset your brain, it's imperative that you no longer expose it to the supernormal stimuli of explicit matter. Huberman said it in the exact same way. If you want to get back to healthy baseline dopamine, you have to remove the stimulus. That's what we're talking about here. So start with a 30-day washout period, then keep going, of course. No porn, no masturbation, no edging, no lusting, no dating apps, no social media that's hypersexualized. I know what you're thinking. What am I going to do? Well, instead, what you're going to do is get outside every single day. Sunlight exposure. Do cold plunges. They'll give you healthy dopamine spikes. Call a friend. Connect. Get a journal. Reflect on your thoughts and feelings. You will be feeling better every single day. Make sure you capture it. Crush some workouts. Get a boxing bag like me. Decimate the general. That's what I call him. Crush it. Strength training. Work out to exhaustion. No, you don't keel over. What you do is feel great. This isn't about punishment, and it's not even about giving up something that you want. I know you think you want it. It's the dopamine that's telling you that. But ultimately, if you want to have the life that you deserve and that you know you want on the inside, porn is not part of it. It's taking you away from that life. You have to wake up that prefrontal cortex. You have to take the power and control back. If you want help with this, and most people need help, if you want a personalized plan, please reach out at drtrishleigh.com. Go over there, check it all out, and see what you can do to gain control quickly. Download my Pleasure Pathway Reset Guide. It's a really good first start for you to understand what's happening in your brain and what you can do to get that control back. Subscribe to this channel. There's thousands of videos here. Go back. They have brain hack strategies that will help you. Click the video that's coming on the screen next. This isn't just about dopamine. It's actually very complex. This is a deep end issue, and I cover it all here. So, right now is the time to get your mind over explicit matter. Let's go, my friend. You can do this.